And we're watching the ingredients come together now for this nor'easter that'll be forming and making its way up the eastern seaboard as we go through the mid and then late week. This is part number one down here moving across Alabama tonight. And the other portion of the storm still back up here in the northern plains. The two of them, though, eventually will get together and we'll talk about that. Overnight tonight, we're looking at mostly clear, cold conditions here. 24 to 30 degrees. New Cumberland, by the way, in the background here. Sunny in the morning, but a chilly, a frosty start to the day. You might actually need that scraper for the first time for the car windshield tomorrow morning. Mostly sunny in the afternoon and chilly. It's going to be 46 to 50 degrees out there. Chilly, chilly. In fact, 34 degrees right now in the capital, 27 in New York, 33 in Lancaster, 36 in Lebanon. Carlisle's at 38 degrees, Gettysburg 31. On the Almanac today, again, way below average. The daytime high should be at 58 degrees, and we got to 45. We'll likely eclipse that. Climb a couple of degrees above 45 tomorrow, but still be running below average. It looks like as we get into the weekend, we'll finally start to see some numbers come back to where they should be and probably actually get a little bit higher. At the moment, it's 34. There are still a few clouds around. Winds have slowed down substantially. They're from the northwest at 5 right now. It's a pretty blustery, breezy day today, but winds will settle down overnight tonight. And tomorrow, they won't be as gusty as they have been for the last several days. All the river stages reporting slowly falling or falling stages right now. That's good news. Harrisburg's at 5.4. How much precipitation we get out of this coming storm, still a big question mark. All depends upon the track of the storm. But when you step out the door in the morning, it's going to be chilly. This is about 8 a.m., so standing in line to vote, expect temperatures close to 30 degrees. And in the afternoon, if you're headed out around 3 o'clock, still in the mid-40s. Fortunately, you should have some sunshine to vote in tomorrow. The skies are looking pretty good out there. As you can see, still a few clouds lingering over the northern tier of the Commonwealth here. But basically, high pressure's building in, so our weather's going to be pretty quiet through the night tonight, tomorrow, and then a little bit more than 24 hours from now, we'll start to see some more clouds come in as this storm starts to turn the corner and head up the coast. This is what it looks like on the predictor. Beautiful skies for us tonight and tomorrow. This area of low pressure comes across Georgia, northern Florida tomorrow, and by, say, midday, it's starting to turn the corner and head up the eastern seaboard. Notice how this area of low pressure is waiting right back here in the wings. As this one starts to climb the coast, spreads clouds our way in time for Wednesday morning, this other area of low pressure hops on board and really invigorates this coastal storm, really starts to cause intensification here. This is Wednesday morning. Watch what happens. Starts to move up toward those affected areas along the coast. Already high wind watches are in place for the Jersey Shore on up toward Long Island. And we'll get windy here, too. Look at where the precipitation shield is. Notice the color of the precipitation shield. Not necessarily all liquid for Wednesday night into Thursday, but just approaching the Susquehanna Valley. And this is going to be one of those hair's breadth kind of things, I think, with the track of this storm. We may actually see that dividing line between no precipitation and precipitation right here in the Susquehanna Valley. So we'll watch the track of the storm. We'll be able to fine-tune that a bit better for you, maybe as early as tomorrow. Today, there's still quite a bit of dissension amongst the computer models as to the final track of this. By Friday, we'll still have breezy conditions, but note the temperature trend there, up. It's going to cool down in the western portion of the country. As a result, we'll start to warm up in the eastern half, about 60 for Saturday and Sunday. So that would be a nice turnaround after what could be a pretty gusty time of it, I think, Wednesday, Thursday, maybe even into Friday.
We'll see what happens.
Just what nobody needs.
Right.
All right. Thank you, Doug.